So basically, well, that's yours. You can solo
that's
there.
When we vamp.
That's when we vamp. Okay.
That's the end?
That's it. That's the whole song.
Yep, 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 yep.
And right when we get to that section, if you... Y'all just literally go crazy. And after that solo, definitely keep the energy going high when we get to that B section. Make sense? Yeah.
It'd be a nice fade out. Let's do it again.
Yeah, let's go on again.
That was nice. That was killing. He gonna start embellishing, but we gotta count. Cause you was on live. That was killing though. Let's do it again. Energy's up. Let's get it.
So Michael, that's a pretty beautiful guitar.
Yes, it is. So this is the D'Angelico Soho custom model by Mark Whitfield. This guitar is absolutely incredible. We're going to be discussing today kind of just the specs and so forth of it, and also just kind of the recording process of how we were able to record the last 8 songs that we did with Jesus Molina, Joe Cleveland, Paige Cooper, and Deuce. Really incredible recordings, sponsored by Warren Hewitt himself and D'Angelico rep Justin here. In the corner. I don't know if you can see him. just an absolutely incredible group of musicians, group of equipment, group of audio technicians, Eric holding the camera, and,
You're too kind. Eric is the man. Go, Eric.
And guitars, of course, so.
I absolutely love this. First of all, when you took it out of the case the other day, I was like, what's that? And it's interesting with Justin just saying that one of the guy behind with Justin designed this, used to work with George Benson. And the first time I played it, I was like, you know, it reminds me of like a GB10, but in all the best ways.
Yes.
I think I might prefer it. And I love the George Benson guitar, but it's gorgeous.
No, this guitar is honestly one of the most easily playable guitars I've ever touched in my entire life.
By the way, this is not sponsored. This is not a sponsor.
No, I'm being 100% honest.
I'm not getting one. I have to buy one, okay? No, it's beautiful.
This is, honestly, you know, the arch top and the floating pickup and so forth, and just the finish and the pickguard and everything about it, you know. I'm a big fan of simplicity. You know, I love satellite amps, you know, where they just have a couple knobs, you know, a tone volume, because I think simplicity is where you find a lot of creativity, actually. You know, a lot of times guitars can go way over the top, you know, with 1,000 different tone options and so forth. But
sure.
For me, you know, coming from a traditional bebop background, a lover of Joe Pass, you know, and Jim Hall and all these guys who played archtops, this is the perfect mixture to me of modern and classic jazz guitar, because I just love the simplicity. Because for me, if I can get a warm sound, you know, just from the tone knob, you know, and turning off all the anything to do with tone, you know, I can really...
Oh, no, I like the first note choice.
No, but, it's beautiful.
But there's just a lot of options when it comes to such a simplistic model. I really fall in love with that. And for me, you know, primarily playing R&B and jazz and funk and so forth, this kind of fits all the genres that I want.
What I love about it is, first of all, acoustically, it projects.
Yeah.
It's super even. I don't know if it's going to come through on a lav mic, but it's so even. Doesn't have that like skinny twee little sound on the high strings. It's everything is super balanced. I know it's going to be that guitar that you're just going to, it's the everyday guitar, isn't it?
It
it's
is.
The one you're sitting in front of the TV, you know, just practicing. It's the one you want to play live.
It's easy because, you know, I go out on my porch in the morning and this is the guitar that I pick up. You know, I have beautiful archtops from Eastman, you know, Gibson and so forth. But for me, you know, I love electric. You know, I love the ability to have diversity. And because this has such a projection acoustically, I'm able to practice all the time.
I think one other thing for me, is like, you know, Gillard and all these guys that play, and Gillard's obviously one of the greats, they all play these incredibly expensive, beautiful, but incredibly expensive handcrafted guitars that are in the 10,000s and plus. And it's interesting, and finally a manufacturer's figured out, let's make a guitar that's affordable like that, because all of them play something like this, a smaller body, not quite as deep, a little bit more useful for playing shows, and just being an everyday guitar.
Yep.
And there isn't much. Gibson make a Howard Roberts, which is a great guitar, but it's not quite this. Obviously, Ibanez make the GB10, the George Benson. But this is one of the few. And you and I have talked many times, and I've told many people, I want a guitar that like this, and then you bring one down and ruin my day because I can't actually get it yet. It might be available by the time this video comes
out. It's unreleased as of right now, but honestly, you know, and for me too, I like stability in terms of tuning, right? And so for me, one thing that I've loved about this particular D'Angelico model is the fact that we have tuning locks on the back that can tighten. That's a super big deal to me. One of my all-time favorite guitar players, Julian Lage. It's funny to see a lot of the higher echelon guitar players, you know, sit in live concerts for 5-10 minutes tuning. And for me, you know, as a performer, as a touring musician, as a musical director, you know, tuning is something that has to happen very fast. Absolutely. You know, especially if you're switching guitars, especially if, you know, you're playing multiple instruments. And so it's extremely productive to have something like this on the back that doesn't feel like a burden, you know, because I've played a lot of guitars with different tuning mechanisms and so forth, and D'Angelico does a really great job of this, that just kind of get in the way, you know, and this for me is extremely easy. It feels flush. Everything about this, you know, this finish right here and the fact that it matches all the tuning pegs and so forth, it's just really beautiful and gorgeous.
They've got a really good balance. There's a couple they make which I like, but they're very ostentatious.
Yeah.
Because of all the gold and the logo and everything, all of which is beautiful, don't get me wrong. It looks like classic New York Italian.
Yep.
I'm presuming that's the heritage. That's what it looks like. You know, so there's a little bit of that kind of like, yo, I'm Italian. This one has got the balance.
Yes. No, I fell in love with it the second I looked at it, you know, and the second I played it, honestly. You know, for me, it takes a while to sit into a guitar. And I can honestly say that this is the fastest that I've ever been attached to any guitar.
Can you tell we're a fan of this guitar?
No, and you know, the funny part is, you know, we're not being overly boastful about this. You know, this is really just a remarkable guitar, a remarkable transition from classic D'Angelico archtops.
We're not getting paid to talk about it.
No, it's the truth, you know. When choosing which guitar to play on which song, you know, you know, it just fit with the song. And for me, that's the most important part, because whenever I'm recording, especially with incredible musicians like Jesus Molina, Joe Cleveland, and Deuce, and Paige Cooper, you know, it's like, these guys really push me as a musician, and that's what I love. And so when I'm choosing and crafting these songs, you know, I am orchestrating them in a way that I'm trying to bring out the best melody, but I'm also trying to push myself, right? And so even with this first chord, you know, with a bunch of fifths, you know, it's something that is challenging for me initially, but I want to have those things that are different, you know? You know, all those different types of mechanisms to me initially are foreign, but I want to create sounds that are, you know, either exotic or beautiful or both, or maybe the complete opposite, you know, a lot of tension. You know, for me, the abstract things that we can make sound beautiful is where I kind of find joy. And again, you know, just in selection of guitars, you know, for me, when we recorded Rap Snitches on this album, you know, this wasn't the guitar for it. And that's okay. And it doesn't have to be the guitar for everything, but for Family Ties, you know, and for Giant Steps. That just fit a lot better. You know, that sat really well with me. Not to say that, you know, this DC tour series, which we should probably mention in a second, because we did record two songs with this as well. It's not that that didn't suit it or it couldn't be played on that. It's just that this is where I found home in those songs. And I think that in music, you know, when you're trying to create a melody that can touch someone and that can mean something and say something, you want to have an instrument and you want to have a toolkit that can accentuate that, you know?
I was thinking about what's the difference between the feel of that guitar and other guitars and why I love it. I feel like nothing's in the way.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? I don't feel like I'm holding a neck. It feels like I'm more attached to it.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? I think the hollow body I've always loved, because you just feel the vibrations against your body. It's much more preferable for me than playing a solid body or even a semi-hollow, you know,
yeah,
which I have no problem with, don't get me wrong. I just feel like it's, you're just completely connected to it.
Yes. You know, and on this this DC yeah. tour series, you know,
let's throw you this.
We can switch out real quickly, and I'll give you this beautiful guitar.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And I'll exchange it for this beautiful
again.
Guitar. That was a joke that Warren made to me the first time I showed it. I said, well, would you want to borrow it for a couple days? And he said, you know, I don't think you'll ever get it back. And I don't think he was joking about that.
It's so slinky. Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous.
It's honestly one of my favorite guitars I've played in years. That just felt a lot better to me, you know. You know, not to say that I couldn't do that on this guitar, you know, but that's just kind of where my fingers led. And again, you know, I think it comes back to the guitar and the player and that relationship. And this guitar, really is absolutely beautiful. I'm a big blue fan. My favorite color is turquoise, you know, which initially attracted me to this.
They're going to have the arguments. Is blue? Is turquoise green or blue?
Is it though?
I think it's blue as well.
Is it blue? I think it's more blue. But yeah,
I'm with you.
You know, I love this guitar too. It's hard for me to pick, which is why I like to have both.
Why don't, we'll start just you and you solo, and then once they all come in, we'll play the head, and then you could keep soloing after that. Make sense? Yeah, with the band. You want us with the band? Okay, then we'll do what we originally wanted. So head with the harmony, and then they come in, play the head twice, and then, yeah. Times, and we'll just jump into a solo of Jesus, and then we'll.
So can I fall out and then let you start it?
You can.
So.
You mean for Jesus and solo?
No, I'm talking about when you go to the that part.
I'm confused.
He means the coda part. You know,
oh yeah. I was just gonna comp that underneath Jesus and solo once I was done playing the head. Yeah,
you switched tempos. I was just wondering.
No. Right. My bad then.
Yeah, that's what he was saying. We can't do it that fast. He wasn't talking about it.
Yeah, exactly. Perfect. I mean, the problem is I can't play the head that fast. I mean, that'd be crazy. But we could switch tempos and do that. I would not be opposed to that. So we could go like this.
I think you should start it.
Yeah, and I can start it. And then the way out of that is that Jesus cues when his solo is done, and we go into halftime, and I'm able to play the head again. All right. Make sense?
Let's try. Because when you say halftime,
so if we're going.
We're not talking about time. We just want to speed it up.
No, after.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see.
We'll see. We'll find out.
Thank you.
Gary.
Yeah, so he wants flat 13, not flat 9. Intro, band comes in, cuts, double time. Once Jesus cues it that he's done, we drop out again. And I'll honestly, the whole band could just drop out and I could just play that line again. And you guys can just come in on it. And then I'll just solo and cue in with them.
Heck yeah.
Dope. Let's run it.
Thank you.
I wasn't thank.
That was crazy. We recorded that, right?
Yeah, yeah. Wow. Yeah, it was fantastic.
That was
beautiful. Can we do one more?
Yeah, I'm down.
That was one insane more? In all the right ways.
Thank you.